When you're developing Kubernetes applications using Minikube, you need to ensure that your Docker image that you want to run in your pod is available to Minikube. The simplest thing you can do is to just build your Docker image and then publish it to a remote registry like Docker Hub, and then have Minikube pull this image and run it. Sadly, the simplest thing is also rather time consuming and not always convenient, especially if you're developing a proprietary application, in which case you probably need a private Docker registry, which will cost you money, and Minikube will require proper authentication and authorization for it to pull the images. But you can also use your local Docker images directly into Minikube without having to upload them to a registry first. And in this video, you're going to learn how to do exactly that. Let's get started. So when you're developing a Kubernetes application, this is what your typical workflow looks like. First, you will make some code changes to your application. And now you want to test those code changes out. So you will use Docker Build to create a new Docker image locally. This new image will contain your new code changes that you want to test out. And of course, you will assign this image a new tag, or maybe you will assign it the latest tag depending on your workflow. Now, once your new image is ready, you will publish it to a remote Docker registry, something like Docker Hub or Amazon ECR or Artifactory. This is so that you can make this image available for Minikube to pull. Once your image is published to the registry, you will go ahead and make some changes in your pod specification. Specifically, what you're going to do is you're going to update the tag of the image that you want to pull. Or if it's latest, you're just going to make sure that Minikube is pulling the latest image all the time. And once you're done with this, you're going to submit this new pod specification to Minikube, at which point Minikube cluster will go ahead and pull your new image from the Docker registry, and then it will start running it. And once it starts running it, then you can test your code changes out. And if at this point you realize that now you got to make some more code changes, you will go ahead and repeat the entire cycle. This can easily get frustrating when you're frequently making code changes in your app. You end up with the change, build, publish to registry, pull and Minikube cycle over and over. So how do you configure Minikube to use the Docker image from your local system rather than pulling from your remote registry all the time? The trick here is to ask your Docker client to talk to Minikube's Docker daemon rather than your local Docker daemon, and then build all the Docker images inside the Minikube container. Remember that Minikube runs inside its own container or VM on your computer. Inside Minikube, it runs its own Docker daemon, which runs all the containers, including Kubernetes itself. So the first and most important step is to point your Docker client to Minikube's Docker daemon rather than your local computer's Docker daemon. And you do this by running this command. Let's unpack it. At the moment, if I run a bunch of Docker commands, they run against my local machine's daemon, returning the Docker objects residing on it. This is the default configuration. We always interact with Docker objects on our local system. Now, I have a Minikube cluster running on my local. And Minikube itself is running inside a Docker container actually. This one. On my macOS, Minikube is running inside this Docker container. Container is also the default setting. You could instead be running Minikube inside a virtual machine too. Now inside this container, there is another Docker daemon running that manages all the containers running as part of the cluster inside it. Now, running the Docker env command produces some environment variables. Among other things, this output tells you how to connect to the Minikube's Docker daemon. So when I run eval on this output, I set a bunch of environment variables in my current shell session that point my Docker client to Minikube's Docker daemon. Now, all Docker commands that I will run will actually execute against the Minikube's Docker daemon and not against my own local machine's Docker daemon. Let's verify this. Yep, these images are not on my local system. They are inside the Minikube container. Similarly, all these processes, all these containers are running inside the Minikube container. On my local, there is only the Minikube container itself that's running. Also note that this change is only for this terminal session. If I open up a new terminal and try to reach out to Docker daemon again, it'll actually reach out to only my local daemon. This is because those environment variables were exported only for this session. Now, if you're using a custom profile for your Minikube cluster, make sure to specify that custom profile's name. Let's say I make some code changes to my application. Let's see the Docker file as well. Very simple Docker file, runs my Python application. I don't need to make any changes here, just need to build a new image now. My app 0.0.1. Okay. Cool. As you can see, this time the image got built inside the Minikube container because we were using the Minikube Docker daemon. And if I try to find it on my local, it's not there. I also never pushed this new image to any remote registry, so Minikube can't really pull it from anywhere. So now let's set the image name and tag in my pod specification. My app 001. Another important thing, also make sure that the image pull policy is set to never. This means Kubelet will never pull the image from a remote registry. It will always try to find it on the local machine, and if it finds it, it will start the container. Otherwise, the startup fails. And finally, let's apply these changes. There. The pod is running, so the container was started successfully, which means Kubernetes was able to find the container image despite it not being present in a remote registry like Docker Hub. Notice the log here, container image is already present on the local. This is the confirmation that Minikube actually picked the image up from local. So I simply pointed my Docker client to Minikube's Docker daemon and built my image. Then Minikube was able to simply use that image from the local itself. This improves my development workflow so much because now I don't have to keep pushing my image to a remote registry just so Minikube could pull it back inside my system. So this is how you can force Minikube to use your Docker images from the local system itself. There is one caveat you should be aware of. The Docker env command only works with single node clusters. Works. Let's start a new Minikube cluster with two nodes. You get this error. So when using multi-node clusters with Minikube, use the registry add-on. I hope this video makes you more productive. I create a lot of content to help you solve the most practical problems in the world of DevOps. If there's anything specific you want to learn, drop a comment below and let me know. See you next time.